Hey guys, so I was scrolling through the internet, just minding my own business, looking through NFL, NBA stuff like I usually do, and I came across this artist who designed some really cool NFL jerseys. Now they're inspired by the City Edition jerseys that Nike made for the NBA, but this guy made it for the NFL. So let's take a look and talk about each of them. Starting off here with the Arizona Cardinals, we have this jersey, which he says that is inspired by the desert of Arizona and also the sunsets in the state. So it's very similar to the Utah Jazz basketball team's City Edition jersey. It kind of inspired by that, I'm guessing. So I really like this jersey, and I think it's pretty good for the Arizona Cardinals. Next up, for the Atlanta Falcons, we have a completely pink jersey, and it's inspired by Georgia rapper 2 Chainz. It took inspiration from the Pink Trap House, which is in Atlanta, which he created originally for his album, Pretty Girls Like Trap Music. And I actually really like this jersey for the Atlanta Falcons because it's a little bit different than their normal black and red color. Pink is totally out there, and it's just a really good jersey idea for them. For the Baltimore Ravens, we have a jersey inspired by the Baltimore City flag. And although the colors are just straight purple, this one is a really cool design because of the patterns that are pretty unusual, and it's just not a simple all one color jersey. So I really like this for the Baltimore Ravens. I think maybe adding some yellow in it would change it up a little bit, but overall, pretty decent jersey. For the Buffalo Bills, this jersey is inspired by just snow because in the wintertime, it snows in Buffalo. I'm sure many of you guys have seen Buffalo Bills games in the snow where there's like a foot of snow and stuff and the players still play. It's pretty cool, and I like how it's completely white with some little touches of blue, and I think this works really well and would contrast really well with like a darker colored team that the Bills would play. For the Carolina Panthers, this jersey is inspired by the Charlotte Motor Speedway, and apparently they're known as like a city that has a lot of racing. I wasn't aware of that. I thought that was more of like Indianapolis. But I do like this jersey. I think it's a little bit more unique. It doesn't use the standard colors that the Panthers have. It looks like tire tracks on the shoulder pads, which I kind of like a lot. And I like this jersey because it's just something different, nothing too similar that the Panthers ever had before. So for the Chicago Bears, the artist designed this jersey in inspiration from the Chicago City flag. As you can see, the stars on the sleeves, and it's just generally that light blue color. It doesn't have the white that the flag typically has, but it has like this dark bluish color that the Bears kind of go with. And it looks like the stars are either orange or red. I'm leaning towards orange because that's what the Bears colors are. It's a decent design, but I know a lot of the City Edition Chicago Bulls jerseys are similar to this, so I guess that's what he got it from. He couldn't really come with anything else. For the Cincinnati Bengals jersey, this one's inspired by the Squirrel Hunters, which was a militia during the Civil War that defended from a Confederate attack. And they were basically just farmers and everyday people that joined up in a militia to defend their city. This jersey looks pretty cool. I like how it has the stripes across the sides, and I really like the design of the numbers. It just really adds to it. It looks like maybe linen or cloth or some kind. The colors really work for the team as well, so I'm a big fan of this jersey. It's a pretty interesting topic as well. For the Cleveland Browns, this jersey is inspired by the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and also Cleveland's history of rock music in general. This one basically just uses a Browns orange color with brown sleeves. And this is the Baker Mayfield jersey. And then right in the middle, it looks like it has 5 or 6 guitar strings right down the middle of this. And it's just a really cool jersey. It's a very simple design, but I'm a big fan. For the Dallas Cowboys, this Ezekiel Elliott jersey is inspired by the city of Dallas in general. It's just a up-and-coming city. It's been growing pretty quickly. So this one doesn't really have a specific design that's dedicated to the city, but it's just a little bit futuristic and a little bit more modern with the purple, green, and blue neon colors, and then just a darker blue background for the jersey. So it's a pretty cool design, pretty futuristic, and I kind of like it. For the Denver Broncos, this jersey is actually really similar to the Buffalo Bills jersey that we talked about earlier. It's basically just inspired by the snow, but in this case, more specifically, ski resorts that are in the Colorado area. Colorado is really known for the Rocky Mountains, where you can ski really well, and this is the jersey. It's all completely white, and it looks like maybe a ski patrol badge on the side. So it's a very cool jersey, very simple, looks cool. Now, this is pretty predictable, but for the Detroit Lions, this jersey is inspired by the car industry and automobile industry in Detroit. I believe he's more specifically going for the racing stripes on the Ford Mustang, and this is what it is. It's just a blue racing stripe on the jersey with a white background. It has the Detroit Lions colors, and it really resembles the city really well, so it's a really good city edition jersey. For the Green Bay Packers, this jersey is inspired by the meatpacking company that really supported the Green Bay Packers when they first were created. And a lot of previous years, the Packers actually had an alternate jersey similar to this, which has this dark bluish color with the yellow. So this idea is not really too revolutionary. It's been done before by the actual team, so I'm not a big fan of that part, but I do like the thought and the idea behind it. So pretty cool jersey nonetheless. For the Houston Texans, this jersey is inspired by the spacesuits used by astronauts, especially for the moon landings and such. Houston was really well known for being NASA's headquarters, where they launched most of the rockets that they launched up to the moon and all. So that makes sense for why the team resembles NASA. So it's a pretty cool design. It has NASA on the shoulder pad. I'm not sure if any legal consequences would come with that if they actually use it in the game. I don't know, this is just for fun. But overall, this is a cool design. It uses mostly NASA colors, which I like. It really works for the team. For the Indianapolis Colts, this jersey basically goes away completely from the idea of the blue and the white that the Colts typically wear. And instead, it's inspired by the racing that goes on in the city. As I've said previously, it's really big deal in that state in Indiana. So this one looks like a checkered flag on the collar part, which I'm a big fan of. And I like how it's a little bit gray. It's not just completely white. And the flag patterns on the shoulder pads. Big fan too. So I think this is a really unique design and really cool as a jersey. So when I first saw this Jacksonville Jaguars jersey, I thought it was supposed to resemble a soccer uniform from like the UK, because the Jaguars are known to be like a London team. I thought it was some kind of joke here. But instead, when I read about it, this is actually inspired by the Blue Angels, which is like a plane flying team, and they do a bunch of cool stunts and flips in the air. So if you're ever at an air show, check them out. But this is a pretty cool idea, and that's apparently because they started in the city of Jacksonville. So it makes sense for the team, and the colors are totally different, but the idea is pretty cool for the Jacksonville Jaguars. For the Kansas City Chiefs jersey, this one is inspired by the grill masters and just the barbecue that goes on in Kansas City and the whole state of Missouri. If you've ever had Missouri barbecue, you know it's delicious. Some of the best grill masters in the world come from Kansas City. And this jersey is really cool. It has like that little bit extra smoke on the bottom of the jersey, and it gets lighter as it goes up. And I do like how it's like this burnt little red color for the numbers and just the accents on the jersey. So it's a very cool jersey. I'm a big fan. It's very original. For the LA Chargers, this jersey is inspired by palm trees that are in Southern California and specifically LA as well. And the numbers on the jersey are supposed to represent like length of the tree, and then the sides of the jerseys where the sleeves are like a palm design. And I would have personally done something else except for just a white background, maybe like a light blue color. I think that would really work for the Chargers. But this one doesn't really have the normal colors. It has like the colors of the palm trees within the numbers, but not a big fan of this one, to be honest. I don't really like this jersey. For the LA Rams, this jersey is inspired by the Los Angeles Fire Department, and California is known for having huge wildfires, especially as of late in the past few years, and the firefighters do a great job trying to tame it, trying to control the fire so people don't really get hurt. So this is honoring them by having just a completely yellow jersey with the red firefighter inspired number part and the green neon on the shoulders. So it's a very cool design, very original. Not many jerseys really honor the fire department in LA, so it's a pretty cool jersey. For the Miami Dolphins, this jersey is inspired by the Miami Vice colors. It has the pink and the blue, the neon, and then the background is a little bit black. I would have preferred a white background possibly, but I do like the design, and I know a lot of you also love the Miami Vice colors for any Miami team. So it's also inspired by the Miami Vice NBA jersey that the Heat wear, so I'm sure that's where he got it from, but it's a very cool jersey. I kind of like it. For the Minnesota Vikings City Edition jersey, this one is basically exactly the same as the Minnesota Timberwolves in the NBA jersey, the City Edition. It was inspired by Prince, who is a great musical artist, and it's inspired by his song Purple Rain. So it's not an original idea, but it works for the Vikings. For the New England Patriots, their uniform is inspired by the Continental Army during the Revolutionary War. The completely blue jackets with the red accents. So that's basically what this jersey is. It has like an older style font as well for the numbers on the Tom Brady jersey, obviously. And I do like the red accents on the sides of the jersey. So it's pretty cool. And I think it really resembles the militia's uniform. For the New Orleans Saints, this uniform is inspired by the historic neighborhood of New Orleans called Treme. That's basically where jazz music came from in New Orleans. Also, this uniform resembles brass band members, jazz music that came from New Orleans. That's what it was played on, brass instruments like trumpets. So this jersey is pretty simple. I personally don't like it as much, but I see where the inspiration comes from. For the New York Giants, this jersey is inspired by their police department, the NYPD. It's really well known across the world. There's plenty of TV shows made about the NYPD, and this jersey basically resembles their uniform. It's pretty accurate, just the basic white font, and the jersey is like a darker blue, very dark, and then it has a badge on the side. Once again, I don't know about the legal implications of that, possibly if they actually implemented it, but other than that, it's a very cool jersey and honors them pretty well. For the New York Jets, the artist decided to honor the New York City Fire Department. And this is what the uniform that they wear. They're really well known for saving a ton of people during the 9/11 attacks, which were terrible, but is really well done because of the neon green part and the black, and it just really resembles their uniform. It's very different to the LA Rams jersey that we looked at earlier, but very cool jersey nonetheless. For the Oakland Raiders, this jersey is inspired by the Black Hole, which is their stadium. That's the nickname for the Raiders stadium. And this jersey basically is just completely blacked out. The number is a lot more black than the jersey color itself. I'm guessing on the field it would just all look one color. It's like a more of a dark gray, not a black, but whatever. We'll accept it. So this is an interesting idea. I would have liked something a little bit different, maybe something honoring the city of Oakland. I don't know, maybe that would be better than just completely black, but that's what the artist did. So it's a decent looking jersey and the design is pretty sleek. For the Philadelphia Eagles, this jersey design is very original. It's inspired by the font of the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air TV show. As we know, Will Smith, the actor and the, I guess, rapper, is from Philly. And when he made that show, it was him leaving Philadelphia and going to Bel-Air. That was what his character was doing. So this jersey basically resembles that. And I love the neon green part of it. It's kind of similar to the Kelly green that a lot of Eagles fans really want. But the numbers and the font are just this yellow and pink, which the title of the actual TV show had as well. So pretty cool design. It's very different than anything I've ever seen before for the Eagles. For the Pittsburgh Steelers, this jersey is inspired by the steel industry that was in Pittsburgh a few years back. And it's just basically a completely silver grayed out jersey. But I do like on the numbers and on the sleeves how it's a little bit subtle, like textured of steel. And it just looks really cool and really adds to this jersey. So I'm a big fan of this jersey, even though it's all basically completely gray. For the San Francisco 49ers, this jersey resembles the Golden Gate Bridge that is associated with the city of San Francisco. It uses the structure of the bridge for like the numbers and the shoulder pads, but also the colors, the orange of it. So it's a pretty decent design and it's pretty unique as well. For the Seattle Seahawks, this jersey is supposed to be in honor of grunge music, which came from Seattle. A lot of bands that were mostly grunge used a blue Fender Mustang guitar, so that's what the jersey resembles the most. And it has that light blue color, and it has the brown in the number itself. So it's a pretty cool design, and it's honoring grunge music, which comes from Seattle, so it's honoring the city as well. So it's a pretty cool jersey. For the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, this jersey is honoring the Ybor City neighborhood of Tampa. And a lot of architecture in that part is Spanish inspired. So that's what this jersey is supposed to resemble. It has like this curly three and a lot of textures and the orange color that I'm sure is seen throughout the neighborhood. So it's a pretty interesting design, very unique. Never seen anything like it before. And I learned some interesting stuff about Tampa Bay as well. Nashville, Tennessee is known as the Music City, so it makes sense that the Tennessee Titans jersey would be modeled about something about the music industry. So in this case, this jersey is modeled after the Grand Ole Opry design, which is a music hall in Nashville, which features a ton of country music artists every year and has a huge country music heritage. So it makes a lot of sense. The design is all completely red with this country music style guitar 8, and it looks like the ceiling supports from the actual venue are used on the shoulders of this jersey. So it's a very cool design, very unique, and I kind of like it. Finally, for the Washington Redskins, this jersey is inspired by the Illuminati and just secret societies that possibly could be running the city of Washington, D.C. No one really knows, but it's a very interesting design. It has the Freemason symbol on the collar part. It's very wacky and very secretive, so it's a very cool design and probably makes sense for the city of Washington.